Hey Sivis Luggers, welcome back to my channel. My name is Zakia and today is the 12th fast of Ramadan. I'm going to be expecting some guests, so I've been really busy in the kitchen. So I'm going to be sharing with you the dessert that I made for my guests today, which is a rose and pistachio falooda pudding. Now, through my travels around the world, I've been kind of confused with regard to what falooda really is. Because in South Africa, a falooda is a dessert, kind of like a mixture between a panna cotta and a jelly. But in the rest of the world, a falooda is a milkshake that is made with ice cream, basil seeds, and rose syrup. But then again, there are many similarities between dishes in different cultures. So, let's start with our rose and pistachio falooda pudding. So to start, I've just placed my saucepan over a plate and I've placed it over medium heat. Add in a liter of full cream milk. And then to this, I'm going to add in 2 teaspoons of China grass powder. Give this a quick stir, making sure that it is completely dissolved and you don't get any thick lumps like this. And as it will heat, you will see that the China grass powder actually dissolves as well. So another name for China grass powder is agar agar powder, and it is a powder that is made from seaweed. So I've given this about 5 minutes to heat and I'm going to add in to the milk and China grass powder 2 tablespoons of ground pistachio. And then stir this again. When you start to see these bubbles around the edges of the pot, we're going to add in our 1/2 teaspoon of ilachi powder or cardamom powder, and I'm going to add in 2 tablespoons of rose syrup. So any brand would do. That's 1 and that's 2. Now you can even make this rose syrup at home, but I'm using a store-bought rose syrup. Look at the beautiful pink color that comes out of this with just 2 tablespoons of rose syrup. At this stage, we're just going to leave everything in the pot and wait until the mixture slightly boils. And at this stage, you can also see that the mixture is thickening. You can see this from the swirls that are happening in the pot. And that is the China grass powder or the agar agar powder that is thickening it. When you see these tiny bubbles appearing on the pot, we're going to switch the stove off . Once the stove is off, we're going to add in a 385 gram can of condensed milk, so basically the entire can. And if you like, you can actually put half the quantity, but it actually gives it a nice creamier texture. And then just whisk this. So remember, the pot is switched off. And And to this, I'm going to add in a 290 gram can of dessert cream. And then just whisk everything together. So you'll notice that it does start to get clumpy, and that is why we need to whisk it. And after whisking, this is how thick it needs to be. Remember, this still has to set in the fridge. And if you're also not too happy with the color, you can add in a tinge of food coloring. Then directly from the pot, I'm going to pour this into my dessert bowls. So this is my rose and pistachio falooda dessert that is ready to be placed into the fridge. And I'm going to just garnish this with some chopped pistas. And some dried rose petals. And as you can see, this has made 12 small bowls. So it should be about 150 ml bowls. Doesn't this look beautiful? I'm sure my guests are going to enjoy this evening. So this would usually require about an hour in the refrigerator to set. And yeah, so we've still got about 6 hours until iftar. And you can see that this is already almost starting to set. And it hasn't even been 10 minutes. So this is the texture of the falooda, and you can see that it's got a nice glossy texture, it's not runny, and it tastes absolutely amazing. I obviously have to wait for iftar to taste this, and I hope you're going to give this a try, and let me know in the comment section down below if you've tried it and if you enjoyed it. So as always, I hope you've enjoyed making this dessert with me. And we'll make this at least once at home before Ramadan ends. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.